Hi friends, I hope you are doing good. So it's been 3 months with my car, Volkswagen T-Roc, and many people are asking that I have not put a general walk around and a review of the car. The thing is, already there are many good reviews on YouTube, so there won't be any particular information that I'll be sharing and that has not been shared by other YouTubers. So as you know that I just try to put some unique content, the content that matters the end user. So I have just not put the walk around so far, but I have noted some points which I'll definitely be sharing very soon. But today I'll be sharing some points which I feel Volkswagen T-Roc should have done better in these departments, because since it is a CBU Europe made car, we expect these things to be there, and it's not a cheap car. 19.99 lakhs at showroom. That's a huge amount that you're asking. So, but if you'll ask me that after 3 months, if I'll get a chance to buy a car again, if I'll be having a budget of 20 to 25 lakhs, will it be T-Roc or some other car? And my answer is, it will be either T-Roc, still first choice. My second choice will be Tata Harrier. Third choice will be Skoda Karoq. But as you know, it's quite expensive. If they'll be offering good discount, I'll be ready to spend 25 lakhs on road for Karoq instead of T-Roc. But in 20 to 22 lakhs, since it was 22 lakhs on road, I still believe T-Roc will be my first choice. Second choice will be Harrier. Harrier is just class apart for any person who is looking for a SUV, and I think Harrier is just too good. It has butch, it has safety, it has features. It is much, much better than any other car you get in this segment. So, as you know, today's topic is what things I feel T-Roc should have better, or Volkswagen could have made it a little better. By starting first thing itself, I'll just flip the camera and I'll show you something. So guys, before discussing the points in my car which I don't like, or we can say that where my car needs improvement, I have to say that none of these is a deal breaker. I still love my Volkswagen T-Roc, the way it drives, the features and everything, right? From insulation, from safety perspective, this car is just bang for the buck, I still believe, because it's a Europe made and quality is just impeccable. I just love it to the core. But as you know, no car is perfect. So first point that I would like to discuss is the Europe spec Volkswagen T-Roc top model. It has offline maps. So what they do is, they do have an SD card. If you see the left slot, this one, they do have a dedicated SD card which has offline maps, so you don't need to switch on the Android Auto thing. You just need to have the SD card and maps will work without any internet connectivity or anything. And good thing is, maps will come here also in the speedometer. So in this digital cockpit in Europe, Volkswagen T-Roc, they do have this map thing. Even in the Tiguan Allspace they are providing, but with T-Roc they are not providing this. So it's a huge omission, because not only it looks very stylish, but it is a huge convenience also, because for the maps now every time I have to switch on Google Maps. So this is the first thing that I believe shouldn't have been missed. Second thing is cruise control. Though it doesn't matter much to me, because I'm a sedate driver and I love to have control over things. Even with the lane assist and brake assist, I'm keeping it switched off for now. But cruise control definitely would have been very good, because on plane trips it would have been come handy. So that is omitted, right?
So this is the second feature I believe which should have been there.
Third thing, even humble Volkswagen Polo Comfort Line model comes with a cooled glove box. But this one, though it has a light, it has a good space, but the glove box, it's not cooled. So it's a sad omission for a 20 lakhs plus car. I earlier thought it might be having some cooled area here itself, but neither this one or glove box, none of these is cooled. So this is the third thing that I believe is a big omission. Fourth thing is this non-powered seats. Seats are manually adjustable. As you can see, this is for the height, and this is lumbar support, and this one is for the incline. So this is manual. In a 20 lakhs plus car, you won't expect manual things, especially with the seat adjustment. Kia Seltos, Creta, top models, they do come with electronically adjustable seats. So this one is, so this is the fourth thing that I believe they should have provided this feature. Fifth thing which have disappointed me the most is the grab handle's quality. Even my humble Volkswagen Polo, 8 years old, it has better handles than this Volkswagen T-Roc, and it is very unlike Volkswagen, because with Volkswagen, what I love about Volkswagen is the perfection in each and everything. Even with the hidden corners also, you'll find quality as top notch. It is, but with this car, there are a couple of things where I find that they have cut the corners. So let me show you. The handles do creak. If you see, just hear the sound. See. If I'm holding it tightly, it does creak. So that means this plastic grade, it's not the best. And if I'll press this area, I'll just switch on the light. See. So this is not something that I have seen in the Octavia, Passat, or even in the Vento. I hope it is visible in the video. So this area is plastic. This area is soft leather. So the plastic area, it creaks. And it's not only the passenger doors, it's for the driver and other left side door also. The front ones, they don't creak that much. I'll just try to see. Hold on. Yeah, they creak a little lesser. Yep, not that much, but they do creak. So in this car, especially in this price range, it should not be happening. I hope once their Volkswagen Tiguan is there, which will be competing with Creta and Seltos, it should not have this great quality. It should be better. Sixth thing is again regarding the quality. Though the AC buttons and the stalks near the steering or near the driver's seat, everything feels rock solid and very good to feel. They are built to last, but couple of switches that I don't like are these ones. They feel a little flimsy. They don't feel like a expensive car at all. See, the plastic is kind of very flimsy, like hollow inside. Very flimsy. It doesn't give the premium feeling at all. Though it serves the purpose beautifully. This one also. But front, these ones are okay, because these have rubbery feeling, these three buttons. But and this one for panoramic roof, this one is also good. This one is good too. But again, these for the lights, they are flimsy. They aren't very good to feel. But everything else is good. No complaints whatsoever with the parts quality. Seventh thing is regarding the exterior, but it's not a complaint, it's just a concern.
since the color is dark, I actually wanted a white one or silver gray, but silver gray among the six colors it was not available. White wasn't available either because it was sold out. But this gray color, it's a dirt magnet. Just see. So since it is a dual tone, even if it was white, still roof would have looked like this only. But otherwise also, we are not used to the dark colors because other three cars are white: Polo, i20, Elite and Wagoner. But this one, I have to wipe it off daily and need to wash every month. Eighth point is again regarding the exterior. If you see in Auto Expo 2020 India, the rim design and wheel size was different. But this one, the one in the production model, or the one you can say the one which is there for the sales, the alloy design as well as the wheel size, because this one is 17 inches. The one in the Auto Expo was 18 inches. This one, yes, it is 17 inches. And tires are Bridgestone Turenza, made in Spain. But 18 inches would have definitely looked better on this. It's again a kind of omission. So the ninth point is the cost cutting with the spare tire. Not only it is undersized, but it doesn't have an alloy also. So this tire, first of all, it is Goodyear, made in India. It's not made in Spain like the other ones. This one is made in India, Goodyear, and size is 16 inches. Precisely saying 205 55 16 R16. So, and that too without an alloy. So it's a kind of cost cutting. With Vento and Polo, it's okay if you provide undersized tires, but with this segment, you should have been giving at least same size tire, if not the alloy one. So disappointed a little bit. So the last and 10th point is regarding the driving on lower speeds, especially on the bumpy roads, not on the plain roads like the one I'm driving. On bumpy roads, let me put the seat belt first. Hold on. So on bumpy roads, it never able to decide that should it be in D1 or D2. It keeps on downshifting and upshifting. But I read on Team BHP that sports mode does the trick. So on sports mode, I'm not facing that problem anymore. But sports mode is not for driving on bumpy roads. But on D mode, especially on the bumpy roads, you never find a perfect driving gear. It tends to be on the high RPMs where you want to be it in D2, but it downshifts. Then if you just press the accelerator, it goes in D2, but suddenly it downshifts again. So on bumpy roads, it's not a joy to drive at all, especially if you are driving under 20. But on plain roads, as I'm driving, it's fun to drive. And on highways, none of the cars under 25 lakhs can match Volkswagen T-Roc. So this was a 10th point. I won't say 11th point, but I'll include as a complaint that I don't like this parking brake as an electronic brake. It comes in Civic also, and it might be coming in many other cars. But personally, I would like to have a manual handbrake. This one, not only it is unsafe if you are driving with kids. With seats and all, that is okay if it will be electronic or manual, but with parking brake, it should be, if I'll be in a situation where it's too much steep and there is a car in front of me and behind me, I understand this car has hill hold also, but still I would love to have a manual brake and control my movements with that, in the especially on incline. And I would love to control my movement of the car on lower speeds with a manual brake instead of having this electronic one. Now I need to press hill hold and need to accelerate accordingly, but a manual brake would have been handy. So thanks guys, that's all. As you can see, these are very minor points. No car is perfect. This car provides you 5-star safety in Euro NCAP, and it is imported from Europe. So with that particular thing only, I'm very glad that I have a Euro spec and Euro safety rated car. That is enough for me to have it for at least 6-7 years. And regarding the drive and everything, it's just too good. It brings a smile on my face every time I drive on highways, and I'm just loving it more and more every day. So guys, I hope this video has helped you. Please let me know if you have any questions in the comments, and thanks for your love and support so far. Thanks guys, have a nice day ahead.